Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I've got a great tutorial for you. I'm going to show you how to extract liquid smoke and glass inside of Photoshop. One of the things that seems to be a mystery to a lot of people is making semi-transparent selections inside of Photoshop. Things like glass and liquid and smoke and steam and things like that tend to elude people. So this tutorial is designed to help you make those perfect selections with those almost impossible seeming subjects. So what I've got here is I've got a girl surfing under the water here. We've got a shot of that, and we're gonna use this. We're gonna do an ad, and we're gonna composite some things in here. So I've got a bottle here. We're gonna drop this bottle in, and we've got some smoke we're gonna drop in there, and we've got a cool little twist I'm gonna do with that for an effect. And then we've got some liquid just to kind of show you that we can do that. Now, I grabbed these assets from Adobe Stock, and I encourage you to follow along. Underneath, there's a link where you can grab 10 free images from Adobe Stock. One of the things I love about using Adobe Stock images is that it's completely free to search and use and try the watermark versions. And you only have to pay if you actually want to use them and license them. Also, I'm going to have a link to Photoshop Cafe, and on there, I'm going to list the exact assets that I'm using. So you can download exactly the same photos from Adobe Stock directly into Photoshop, and you can follow along. So let's get started. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to this bottle. Now I've got a couple of things I'm gonna show you, but the first thing I wanna do is I'm just gonna make a selection around the bottle, just like we normally would. And by the way, I just grabbed the quick selection tool there and just, you know, default settings, I'm not changing anything. Just kind of dragging it around that bottle. Now I'm gonna hit the Alt or the Option key and go around these edges to try and get that pretty accurate. So we're just going around those edges. Now another tool that works really well for these hard edges like we're doing here is the pen tool. The pen tool would work tremendously for this. And I've got other tutorials on that, but that's pretty close. We've got pretty close to a good selection right there. I kind of like that, and I'm just gonna tap up here because I feel like I've missed that lip, and I'm just gonna go in there and tap in there. Now to check the selection to see if it's good, just hit the Q key for quick mask, and we can see we're pretty close. I'm just gonna grab the brush tool real quick, and I'm just gonna make the size go small. Just grab a regular one, pull the hardness all the way up, and I just want to just kind of paint in there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the top there, and I'm just gonna hold down the Shift key and drag down, and that'll constrain my painting to a straight line, and that'll save me a lot of time doing that. Do the same thing on the other side, tap, hold Shift, and drag down, and that will constrain my painting. See that? And that enables you to paint in a straight line. You can also tap, and then hold the Shift key and then tap in another place, and it will draw a line in between for you. In this case, I want a little more control, so it's just holding down the Shift, which will constrain it to that movement. So I'm just gonna hit the Q key again to bring this back to a selection. So notice right now our selection's inverted. So we can just choose to select inverse, and as keyboard shortcut, Command-Shift-I or Control-Shift-I on Windows, and now just our bottle is selected. Now I wanna make sure this bottle is a little cleaner, so I'm just gonna grab any selection tool that will enable select a mask. I'm gonna click on there, and all I wanna do is just move to the smooth, and I'm just gonna drag that smooth a little bit just to give myself some smoothening. Now what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna output this selection to a selection, and I'm just gonna click OK, because there's a couple of things I wanna do here. So what I'm gonna do now is I wanna copy just the selected area of that bottle to a new layer. So I'm gonna hold down Control and hit the J key. That would be Command on Mac, Control on Windows, and J. And if you notice what happened, now I've got that selected area and I've still got our background. Well, why did I keep our background? Because now I'm gonna show you how to do the semi-transparent selection on the inside of the bottle. So with this background selected, we're gonna go to select, and we're gonna use the color range. Now, color range is amazing. What we can do with color range is we can choose a color, and let me just set this because this is what yours will look like here. And then with the eyedropper tool, we could just click like maybe here, and that will make a selection there. Then we grab the plus tool, and we can actually just click and drag to select some more of those areas to add to our selection. As you can see what we're doing here, but this is not how we're going to do it. Let's bring the fuzziness down a bit too so you can see better. What the fuzziness does is that it kind of just increases, it spreads it out a little bit. So this is very defined and this is very fuzzy. So you can see it's not bad. We get a pretty decent selection. Now, one of the other things about the selection, where it's white means it's going to be fully selected. Notice we haven't selected that cork, and we can click on it here or we can click on it here. It doesn't matter. And notice we can add that to that selection. So white is fully selected, black is completely unselected, and that area of gray is where the semi-transparent selections work, and we can adjust that by sliding this fuzziness slider. Now, sometimes in a situation like this where it's shot against a pure white background, I'm gonna change this to highlights. And I'm gonna turn my fuzziness all the way down because you know why? This gives me two levels of control now. Now I have the range, and I have the fuzziness. See that? So we can get the range to select everything and the fuzziness to determine how much of that gray area, see that? That's going to be semi-transparent in there. And I'm just going to click OK. And also notice, once again, our selection's inverted. So we could inverse that selection. Or here's another way of doing it. If we're just going to create a mask, if I held down the Alt or the Option key and click on the layer mask, it'll create an inverted mask. And now we've got our bottle. Notice it's got most of it, but some of these areas here are just a little too well selected. And that's why we have this one on top. So we can take that one there and we can adjust the opacity. See that? And then we can adjust how much transparency is going to show through. Now I'm noticing on here though, at the very top here, this is getting lost. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another copy. Control J. I'm going to hide the middle one for now. And now I want to create a mask where everything is hidden. So in order to do that, I'm going to click the mask just like we did. We're going to do an inverted mask. Hold the Alt or the Option and then click on the mask and it will create a mask that's filled with black. A mask filled with black means that everything's there, but everything is hidden. To bring it back, we're going to grab the white brush and we're going to carefully paint back in the areas that we want to see. So let's do that right now. So let's grab a brush. And now I want to change this to a soft edge brush. And I'm just going to make it bigger by tapping the bracket key. And I'm going to bring that opacity down just a little bit, maybe about 75%. So we're painting mostly opaque, but it's still going to be a little bit transparent. So let's just paint over there. And notice what we're doing. We're bringing back in those areas now. And if you want those areas to be completely opaque, of course, you know, you can just paint in those areas again. And that's going to do it. So let's go down the bottom here. I definitely want those areas to show again. Nice. All right. So now the final step is to turn this one back on, drag the opacity all the way to bottom, and then just kind of drag it up to show the amount of transparency that we want to see. So you can't really see the effects of the transparency until we put it on another photo. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move it into the other photo. But you know, if you move house, what do? You grab a box and you put everything in that box. And then you just take that box over. It's a lot easier than trying to juggle everything in your arms. So why don't we do the equivalent here? We're going to make it easy for us to keep everything together and adjust when we move it. Why don't we put it inside a box right now? And the way to do that in Photoshop is just click, shift click. We've selected everything. And now we want to group it into a box. That's the key. So hit Command on Mac, Control on Windows, and G for group. And now we've got that. And we can turn it to, I'm just typing in bot for bottle. All right, now we have created a group. So when I select this now and I move it, notice everything moves together. Now I want to combine the two, so I'm going to drag this up into the other tab. Don't let go yet. I'm using a pen. If you're using a mouse, same thing. Don't let go of that button. See that cursor still black arrow? It's in the middle. And now release. And now you see our bottle has traveled through. So we're going to put our bottle here. And if I want to resize it, I'm going to hit Control T. And or that would be Command T on Mac. And our free transform comes up. Hold the Shift key, click and drag up to do that. And now we can move it around. And notice we've got our semi-transparency that moves with us now. And we can adjust that if we want. So if we want it more or less transparent, we go in here. And here's our little adjustment there. Notice that one. In the middle, if we turn that down, it's more transparent. If we turn it up, it's more opaque. See that? So we can adjust that how we want it. Pro tip. If you want to make it look like there's liquid in there, duplicate that layer and then just create a rectangular selection in the leap part of it. Adjust that opacity independently. And even you could go into hue saturation, add color, and make it look like there's some kind of a liquid in there if you wanted to do that. All right, so we've added the glass, we've combined the glass. Now we're going to move on to the liquid and the smoke. Now, one of the things you might be asking at this point here, and this is something I do get a lot from people, is, well, you know what, that's easy to select because that's against a white background. What about something, you know, against, and I always hear the what abouts when I do tutorials, what if it's against a tree or a more complex, a very busy background? Okay, number one, we're grabbing this from stock. Don't grab stock that's against a busy background. Choose it against an easy background to work with, you know, and if you're shooting your own bottles, it's very easy to hold a piece of white paper behind that bottle when you photograph it. If it's a complex background, my answer to that is, why waste all that time for complex background when you can set up a piece of paper, a sheet, or something like that and make it easier? Reshoot the photo or grab into stock. Don't spend hours trying to, you know, mask out and, you know, it's a waste of time. You use your, you know, use your time wisely so you can shoot more and edit more. All right, so let's continue. Well, now let's go into smoke and we're going to do some cool stuff with this smoke. So here we are with the smoke right now. And we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to choose a select color range. And, you know, we want to get this where it's looking good. Right now we're working on the grayscale. We turn it off to none. We get that. So I want a nice, soft kind of a selection here. So let's just play around with our range. Play around with our fuzziness. See that? And, you know, and if you are watching this, don't skip ahead just yet. I've got a couple more things I really want to show you. So this is looking pretty good. Let's click OK. And now I am just going to click the mask and we've got our smoke. So this smoke is a little bit bigger. Make sure we select the layer and not the mask and click and drag this into here. And notice that this is a pretty big file. We can move this over until we get something that looks kind of cool. We could scale it smaller if we wanted, but I kind of like it big like this. And see how that smoke is just kind of showing through really nicely. So what I want to do is I want to give this a cool kind of an effect. Okay, so here we are now, and I want to like kind of do some things with this. I'm going to hit the adjustment layer, and what I want to do is a hue saturation. So I'm going to grab this hue saturation adjustment layer here, drag this on top, and I want to just affect this layer underneath. Because right now if I do this, it's going to affect everything. See that? And if I want to just affect the layer underneath, what I do is just tap that little tool there. Or go between there and that layer, hold down the Alt or the Option key, and it will now clip it, and as I change it, notice it's just affecting that layer. Okay, so let's increase the saturation. We're going to put some color in here. Now notice it's not having a huge effect, so the lightness, move that lightness down, and now we can really apply that color. Look at that. So I'm going to give it that aqua color, and maybe drop the saturation down just a little bit, and just get it where it's blending in. Now, one of the things I can do at this point here is I can select this and I could drop the opacity down just a little bit. You know, if I wanted to just kind of blend it in a little bit better. Now, I've got a little bit more I want to show to add some more realism. So if we look at this bottle, look behind her. You know, if you were to look at real glass, like a pair of glasses or something like that, and you look through these glasses like that, you know, it's not going to lie. It's going to distort. It's going to displace things through there. And that's called refraction. And we want to put a little bit of refraction in here to make it look more realistic. So there's our bottle. What we want to do is we want to select the bottle. So I'm just going to hit the control key and click there. And notice we've got that selection around the bottle there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the background. And I want to just copy just that area. So I'm going to hit control J. And notice that that's going to copy just that area that's underneath the bottle. So for example, I show you here. We can see that's copied. Now I'm just going to control click to select it because I want to stay within this region. I don't want to go outside of there. And I just want to kind of distort it. So we're going to choose filter and we're going to choose to distort. Now you could play around with all these different settings. What I'm going to use in this case, I'm just going to grab this spherize. Works quite well. And let's pull that up quite big. I'm about 75 right now and click OK. And notice how it distorts everything behind it. And you know what? That gives it a more realistic effect. See how the surfboard's kind of distorting? Her legs are distorting. And that's the kind of effect that you would get looking through a lens. And any semi-transparent object is a lens. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a few little design elements to finish this off. What design elements would you add to this to do a fun ad? Drop that in the comments underneath. I'd love to hear what you would do. What I'm going to just add some type, just do a couple of little adjustments like that just to finish it off. And here's a little tip. If I had the white on the bottle, I add some type on there. I'm going to change that to soft light mode so that it can kind of see through that, so it looks semi-transparent as well. So it also kind of fits in there. So anyway, guys, don't forget, follow along, grab your 10-3 images from Adobe Stock. Now, if you're a shooter and you're shooting objects that we could use, such as, you know, the smoke, the glass, these different types of things, you can become a contributor to Adobe Stock and you can sell that, make a little extra revenue and get your images in front of millions of people. I'm going to put a link under there where you can become a contributor and you can supply the images that, you know, we use for all kinds of different things. So anyway, guys, I hope you liked this. If you did, smash that like button into dust. I'd love for you to get my tutorials. I do at least one tutorial every single week. And all you need to do that is just hit that subscribe button right now. It's free and easy and you'll be informed. But make sure you see that little bell icon there on YouTube. Tap on that little bell for notifications as well. And then you'll know whenever I upload a new tutorial. So anyway, guys, I'd love to hear your thoughts and comments on this. Let me know. I know there's other ways we could do this. So there's things like blend if, there's blend modes, there's lots of different ways that we can do this. But I hope you guys enjoy this technique. I believe this is the most accurate technique for getting really good semi-transparent selections. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.